Let's think of it this way. Think about all these lovely internet companies like Google and Facebook, Spotify. How do they predict what kind of stuff you're going to interact with? You know, the advertisements, videos, posts. How do they predict what stuff you want to see and that you'll click on? Simple. By remembering. By remembering your online history, of course. So remembrance and prophecy are two sides of the same coin. The literary critic Svetlana Todorov writes that prophecy is really an act of remembering. In one of his books, The Conquest of America, Todorov writes that it was understanding prophecies that led Hernan Cortes and his murderous band of conquistadors to defeat the Aztec Empire in what is today Mexico. It was because Cortes understood how prophecy worked, that it's really a kind of remembering. So friends, let's understand that it's not enough to simply recite history. It's not enough to recite facts and figures and dates in our acts of remembrance. We must interpret history. We must prophesy. We heard words of prophecy already from the prophet Micah. Maybe you're familiar with the word, those very similar words from the prophet Isaiah as well, from Isaiah chapter 2. One was either referencing the other, or maybe they were both referencing some kind of song or tradition that they both knew in their time. See, prophets of ancient Israel, were very aware of cycles of war and peace in their nation's history. And perhaps the prophecies about transforming weapons of war into tools of agriculture were acts of remembrance. A modern day prophet, a rabbi named Abraham Joshua Heschel, he wrote that prophecy is not so much about prognostication, meaning predicting the future, but it's about manifesting the pathos or the passions of God. Prophecy is the manifestation of the passion of God. So what is it that excites the passion of God? I can share with you, I am sure that God rages against greed and corruption. I can share with you that God delights in sharing and in justice. I can share with you that God weeps at pain and death and destruction. Prophets remember these things. And by remembering rightly, they prophesy timely. So, my dear friends, on this day of remembrance, how shall we remember? How shall we prophesy? In just a little bit, we will hear the names of the fallen as part of our Remembrance Day commemoration. People who have been part of this church community will read their names. As we hear these names, you may think of other people whom you know who have been lost to the pain and destruction of war. In fact, I invite you to think of those people. As we remember these and others, I encourage you to open your mind and your heart to the divine energy that comes from prophetic remembrance. Friends, let us remember and let us prophesy.